huge mouth, like right as it's coming towards me. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Moved to Cancun. We moved to Cancun.
Yeah, I don't know what people think it is, but I'm pretty sure it's not what they think it is.
Yeah, so we took a break from bus life, rented the bus, and we moved, packed up, that was like 5 suitcases or something like that, and moved to Cancun. It was wild, within a month. But we made it. And the first couple weeks were an adjustment.
Yeah. Definitely a bit rocky as we try to adjust to a new country, new language, new school. So we settled in to a day-to-day life, and we did less adventuring than we expected we would, you know, when we were like, okay, we'll move to this new country. And normally, when we traveled full-time internationally before, we would try and maximize our time there and see and do as much as we could, you know, while still having a good work-home-life balance. But adding cancer and cancer treatments into the mix was just one more thing. So we really just focused on having more stability and routine. And the place where we lived had a pool, so the kids would go swimming almost daily. That was awesome. Yeah. One of the challenges was they didn't really have any toys. We didn't really pack, like, I mean, they packed, like, a few things in their backpacks, like little things. But, you know, kids get bored with little toys and things pretty easily. So they did a lot of listening to audiobooks. They would listen to audiobooks for hours. And he bought a ream of paper, and they just used paper and listened to books and drew pictures.
It was my birthday while we were there. We went to a cenote. We're running wild, we're running free, 'cause there's no stopping. Yeah, you and me. The world is ours now for us to take. It's time to live it and do it all.
You already earned the 50 pesos for jumping.
Yeah, but not like the second time. I'm just like wondering if I still.
What do you mean? If you earn another 50 pesos?
Yeah.
No, just the first time.
No. The
can I do it again?
First time.
Another 50. Nothing can hold us back.
It was really cute to see the kids like going to school and picking up some language. A lot of classmates in Zoe and Cruz classes could speak English, and their teachers could speak English pretty well. So I don't think they were as encouraged and motivated, challenged to learn the language. But Marley's class and classmates were all, you know, Spanish speaking. So that was really cute. You know, one day, I think we were like getting her bread or something. She's like, "Oh, some pan." We're like, "Oh yeah, yeah, bread is pan in Spanish." Like, it was cute. Yeah,
so we don't know how much she learned.
Like, yeah.
How much she understood from going there.
But it was really fun to see, you know, all of us were stretching some and learning some and stepping outside our comfort zone, you know, going to the store and filling up gas and driving on the roads. And
who do I book? Like, do I usually schedule all the dates when we go on dates? I schedule all the dates. Schedule this one, the best one. Anyways. So yes, for our anniversary, we went and...
Yeah, because I like made you. I was like, if you want to go swim with whale sharks, make it happen. Because he was like, this is like top of my list. Like, we came here to do this, basically. And I'm like, okay, make it happen.
So, for our anniversary, we ended up booking it. And when we got there, they're like, so it's... no one has seen any whale sharks yet this year. We were like, oh no. We were like, okay. Visualize.
Just visualizing.
We're gonna
so
see
hard.
It. We're
like
gonna
imagining.
See it.
I'm sending out like, you know, feelings to the whale or the sharks.
Whale sharks.
Sending like all the vibes out to the whale sharks, like inviting them to us. You know, sending them love and light, knowing that they're safe. We're safe. We just want to like admire them, their beauty. And we're like going on like huge. Like it was a
yeah.
Really
it was a little
rough.
Day oh yeah, and they had said too like. So it's a little rough today. Like, we're like, okay, we're on this pretty small boat. Yeah. I was thinking we're gonna be on a bigger boat, but like a fairly small boat. And so like,
yeah. Will you find wings? Will you get back up and see it to the end? Do you hear it in the wind? Well, it's time for flying. And there's no more trying. It's perfect timing for us. We're gonna go.
Boom.
And we'd been looking for whale sharks for about an hour and a half, I think.
At first we saw a big old ray, which they were actually like, they were saying that like, it's pretty early to see really big rays. Then all of a sudden it's like, get your flippers on, get your fins, get your snorkel.
And when he says ray, like, you might be thinking of like a little stingray, like you've seen it like a aquarium or something. No, these things were massive. Like the size of like a big kitchen table, like huge, so big, but I mean small compared to the whale sharks, which was just
it was just awesome. We
like,
had so much fun
like swimming under our boat. Yeah. And like I accidentally touched one. You're not supposed to touch them, but it swam right under me, and I had like put my arms up and its fin like went right under me, and I was just like, oh my gosh, a shark just like gave me a high five with its fin. It like opened its mouth right as it went under me. It was like, oh. Like I see like, you know, this huge mouth like right as it's coming towards me. I'm like, oh my god.
Such a good like, it was towards the end of our time there, and it was like such a high. Yeah. To like, it was there were definitely some lows. There were definitely highs. The weather was so awesome. I feel like we spent so much time outside because it was just like beautiful weather. We were really close to the beach. We could go surfing. The kids could go play at the beach, find shells, go bodyboarding.
I also had a procedure right before we left. That was really, really hard. I spent 4 days in the hospital, and then we celebrated Marley's birthday. You know, like her birthday was the day before we flew back to the States. So it was kind of a whirlwind to get back.
But we did it. We're alive. We're sipping on sunshine. Back, it was hard to leave. Like, we felt like that was like kind of like our home. We were kind of had mixed feelings about coming back, but we also realized we had some unfinished business, it seemed like, with our bus.
We traded all the space and stability and consistency that we had for a bus life and a life full of adventure and surprises.
Constant surprises. Stay tuned.
What? What's yuck? What is that? Is that a booger?
No.
What is it?
It was from my nose.
I think that's a booger.
Oh yeah.
Until we started coming back to the States, where it was like, oh, I don't have to think about what I'm going to say.
I can just like read all the items on the shelf in the grocery store. I don't have to like use Google Translate to like look at all the ingredients and stuff.
Yep.